Hello students, today we shall study the life cycle of Cercospora. Cercospora belongs to the class Deuteromycetes. So Deuteromycetes, it is the last class of fungi. It is also called as fungi imperfecti. Fungi imperfecti because you do not see the sexual reproduction in all the members which belong to the class Deuteromycetes. Order Monilialis, family Dimaceaceae, example is Cercospora. So Cercospora belongs to the class Deuteromycetes, which is also called as fungi imperfecti. Order Monilialis, family Dimaceaceae, example is Cercospora. There are about 3,800 species of Cercospora, and most of them, they live as parasites on the flowering plants, and it causes a disease which is called as the leaf spot disease. So of 3,800 species, most of them, they live as parasites and they cause a disease on the flowering plants which is called as the leaf spot disease. So the most popular leaf spot disease is seen in the groundnut plant. Which causes a disease, a well-known serious disease, which is called as Ticca disease of groundnut. So it is one of the most serious disease in all the groundnut areas, groundnut growing areas. So this Ticca disease is caused by two species of Cercospora. One is Cercospora personata. This is one species, and the other species of Cercospora is Cercospora arachidicola. So both these species causes the disease in the groundnut, which is called as Ticca disease of groundnut. But Cercospora personata is more common in India, and it causes much damage to the plants when compared to the Cercospora arachidicola. So next, coming to the mycelium, or it is also called as the vegetative structure or the plant body. So the plant body of Cercospora is the mycelium. So in all fungi, the vegetative structure of the plant body is mycelium. Mycelium is nothing but a collection of hyphae. So the mycelium is highly branched. The mycelium is highly branched structure, and it is septate and highly branched. So in all fungi, it is septate, highly branched, and it is multinucleate. It has a number of nuclei. So highly branched, septate, and multinucleate. So the hyphae or the mycelium of Cercospora personata varies with the Cercospora arachidicola. In Cercospora personata, it is intercellular in position. That means it grows in between the cells, and it produces a septate branched haustoria. So as it is intercellular, in order to absorb the nutrition, it produces a septate branched haustoria, which penetrates into the host tissue and absorbs. Whereas in case of Cercospora arachidicola, it is both intercellular as well as intra intercellular as well as intracellular. That means it grows in between the cells as well as it grows inside the cell. So as a result, there is no formation of haustoria. So as it can absorb directly from the host tissue, so as a result, there is no haustoria formation. So next, coming to the Tikka disease, the well-known disease of groundnut, which is called as the Tikka. Before that, we shall study the asexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is completely absent. Asexual reproduction takes place by the formation of conidia. Conidia, they are born on conidiophores. Conidia are born on conidiophores. So how it is seen, how this formation takes place? See here, this is the structure of the host epidermis. The host epidermis. So here and there you see the mesophyll tissue, the spongy tissue. So this is the transverse section of the leaf of the host tissue. So just below the stomata, so this hyphae, it forms a mat of hyphae just below the stomata, and this area is called as the substomatal cavity. So here the hyphae, it becomes interwoven to form a mass of hyphae, and this mass of hyphae is called as the stroma. So from this stroma, a number of elongated cylindrical specialized structures arises, and these are called as the conidiophores. So these conidiophores, in turn, it produces an elongated septate conidia. So asexual reproduction takes place by the formation of conidia. Conidia are born on conidiophores. These are all the conidia. Conidia are born on conidiophores. So conidiophores, they arise from the stroma region, which is nothing but an interwoven mass of hyphae, which is present in the substomatal cavity. So these conidia, see, this conidiophores, it may be septate or it may be aseptate. If it is septate, then you see two to three septa is seen. If it is aseptate, no septa formation takes place. So from the tip of the conidiophores, the conidia are seen. So these conidia, when they fall off or when they get detached from the conidiophore, this is the conidiophore. So when they fall on it, it leaves a scar on the conidiophore. See here, when this is the conidia, when it falls off, it leaves a scar on the conidiophore. So usually the conidiophore, you call it as geniculate. Geniculate means you can see the knee-shaped bending of the conidiophore. Knee-shaped bending of the conidiophore, hence you call it as geniculate. So asexual reproduction takes place with the help of conidia. Conidia are born on conidiophores. The conidiophores may be septate or aseptate, whereas the conidia is septate. So these conidiophores arises from the stroma, which lies in the substomatal cavity. So as the conidiophores emerge, rupturing the epidermis, the conidia are exposed to the atmosphere. So when the conidia, when they get detached from the conidiophore, it leaves a scar, and hence it gives a knee-shaped bending to the conidiophore, which is called as geniculate. So this conidia, on germination, it gives rise to a new mycelium. So next, coming to the tikka disease of groundnut. Tikka disease of groundnut, which is caused by two species of the Cercospora, namely Cercospora arachidicola and Cercospora personata. So this tikka disease is a very popular disease, and it is one of the most serious disease of the groundnut. So wherever the groundnut is seen growing, you can see this disease as a common disease which causes much damage to the groundnut plant. So it is caused by two species. One is Cercospora personata and the other one is Cercospora arachidicola. When the plant is about 1 to 2 months old, you can see the spots on the leaves. It is seen both on the upper and the lower surface. So later on, the necrotic lesions, it is seen on the stem. The shape, the size, shape, and the conidia produced by Cercospora personata and Cercospora arachidicola is different. So this Cercospora personata, it produces circular spots, round spots, which are smaller, in size, and it is brown to black in color. The spots are brown to black in color, whereas this arachidicola, the spots are circular to irregular in shape, and these spots are larger. It is reddish brown. This is dark brown, and here these are reddish brown to black color spots. So these spots, they are surrounded by a yellow halo, a ring of yellow halo surrounding the spot. Here there is no yellow halo present here. These are the differences here. And the conidia produced by Cercospora personata is smaller. The conidia is smaller in length. Here the conidia is bigger. It consists of 4 to 12 septa. So these are the differences between the Cercospora personata and Cercospora arachidicola symptoms on the leaves. So the Cercospora personata, it produces circular spots which are smaller in size. These are dark brown to black color, and there is no yellow ring surrounding the spot, and the conidia is smaller. Whereas in arachidicola, it is irregular. Circular to irregular in shape, it is larger in size, it is reddish brown to black in color, and it is surrounded by a yellow halo means a ring of yellow color. Yellow halo is present. So based on this, you can make out whether it is caused by personata or arachidicola. But this personata is more dangerous than the arachidicola. So as a result, what happens? The leaves become very weak, and it becomes dry, and finally premature falling of the leaves takes place. So as a result, the groundnuts become smaller in size and lesser in number, fewer, lesser in number, lesser in number, lesser in number. So management of the disease, management, or it is also called as controlling measures, management or control measures, control measures of the disease. How to control this disease? So most of the diseases can be controlled. Firstly, see, the first one is deep burying of the plant debris. So the infected plant debris, it should be buried, and or it can be burnt. And secondly, rotation of crops, so that the severity of the infection can be reduced. Thirdly, dressing of the seeds with agrosan GN, dressing of the seeds with agrosan GN. And lastly, spraying of fungicides such as Z78 and Blitox 50. So this is how we can manage this disease. So this is about the life cycle of Cercospora.